First time with Raheem Mostert. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal. The impressive opening drive continues, and just space being created by those guys up front.
We're seeing this the same way, aren't we? We are seeing an offensive line, as this game gets started, as it starts to unfold, that they are dominating the line of scrimmage.
Going to the air, Tagovailoa. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, it certainly appears that they're going to try to keep getting him the football. It's the third time they've looked in his direction. Unfortunately, haven't completed one yet, but I'm not sure they're going to shy away from it. They feel like they've got something there, and they want to capitalize on it.
I think you're right. We're only in the first quarter, so a lot of opportunities ahead. They'll go again from the 3 here on second and goal. Mostert will get down close to the goal line, but not in, as he'll be marked down at the 1. Call it a gain of a couple. The defense stiffening here. It's third and goal. No score after 1 on EA Sports. So it's third and goal, and now the question, can this Falcon defense stand tall once more? Here's Tagovailoa to throw. Touchdown, Dolphins! Raheem Mostert from a yard out. And the Dolphins post the first points of the ballgame as they take the lead here in this second quarter. Well, that drive felt like it took up an eternity. We finally have some action on the scoreboard.
Yeah, but plenty of action prior to, because that drive took up all the first quarter before we spilled into the second, and finally, points were registered.
On the other sideline, they're chomping at the bit just to get the football. Extra point up and good by Sanders, and it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And this will wind up way short of the landing zone, so that's going to move the ball all the way up to the 40-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30. Here's Cousins. Got a man, it's London. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run.
And it's a real luxury when you have a guy who can turn a short throw into a solid gain at any moment. Once he caught that ball, he ID'd where the open grass was and got there in a hurry to pick up a new set of downs for his offense.
A run for the first time with Bijan Robinson. And some solid footwork there as he'll take this down to about the 38. It's a gain of 11, and the Falcons pick up the first. Defensively, they were in the 3-4. Solid run up the middle. What made it successful?
Well, what you have to do is control the nose guard, but sometimes you don't do it by blocking him. You do it by influencing him. Get him moving to one side or the other and hit him back on the opposite.
Back to Robinson now on first down. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line. And score that one for one of the league's best. Jalen Ramsey getting the tackle for loss. So a step in the wrong direction. Now they'll look to make amends on second and 14. Now Cousins going to change it up. Second and 14. Knocked away and incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. And now an audible here into something else. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. That is caught. Touchdown, Falcons! Ray McLeod, 42 yards. And the Falcons are an extra point away from evening this one up. No going for two. They'll kick the point after. It's up and good, and we're tied at seven here in corner number two. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And this is not going to wind up anywhere near the landing zone, so this will be blown dead. And they'll move it up to the 40. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. Here's Tua. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
But there's an incompletion, partner, and the struggles through the air continue because so far their lack of passing production has led to a lack of points.
Up the middle they go with Mostert. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one good for 13 at a Dolphin first down. Veteran running back like him, we've seen a lot of those chunk carries in his career.
And that's why you don't just look at his birth certificate and decide when a guy is done, right? Because you know as well as I do, in this league, as soon as you hit 30, they're looking to let you go if you're a running back. Sometimes there's a little tread left on the tires.
And he's over midfield and into Falcon territory. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Good yardage there on first down, exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs, keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
And they'll get this just to the 47, 1 yard gain. He could muster only a yard there, and they'll be left with a third and very short. They'll run for it with Achane. And great blocking downfield as he's got this almost to the 35-yard line. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Again, it's Achane. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It's only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Looking to pass. Tua. Here's a diving catch right side. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. From the gun, it's Tua. Trying to get it to Beckham, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jesse Bates.
And as we've seen, points have been precious so far, and they just threw something away on that snap. And look, let's face it, as we advance further into this game, that play will be on the minds of everyone who's watching it. They wonder if this is the turning point. Is this the spot where those points were given away and could cost them a ball game?
Straight ahead, it's Robinson. Past the 20. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. From the gun, here's Cousins. Got this complete to the tight end Pitts. Touchdown, Falcons! Kyle Pitts from 6 yards away. And the Falcons will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half. That, of course, all set up by the big run on the play prior. They took advantage right away with the touchdown throw.
And you mentioned advantage, probably taking advantage of their natural instinct after that previous play to be aggressive and rush towards the line of scrimmage. And instead, they took advantage.
Extra point by Koo, up and going. And that makes the score 14-7. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And this will wind up way short of the landing zone, so that's going to move the ball all the way up to the 40-yard line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And with just under a minute to go, they might try to think about mounting a drive here if they can and get in the end zone. Could potentially tie this game up. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
I felt that one all the way up here. How about that big man laying out and making that catch?
Yeah, that wasn't a 180-pound wideout. That was a tight end. Tua sets up to pass it. This is Smith with a grab. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
For a tight end, he's got good straight-line speed, and on that route, he's often the guy that gets overlooked. Nice job there finding him in stride for really good yardage.
He'll swing this out to Mostert. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number 1. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. He completes it to Beckham. Touchdown! Odell Beckham in the final seconds of the first half. And the Dolphins have a chance to tie the game here in the final seconds of the half. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. So not much time to work with here. 9 seconds remain in the half as this one is away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And with only 9 seconds remaining, well, not much time, we'll see how they play this. To throw his Cousins. And caught by London. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. Final play of the half, Cousins. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. 2 quarters down, 2 still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And this is not going to wind up anywhere near the landing zone, so this will be blown dead, and they'll move it up to the 40. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
55 yards rushing for him now to this point.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive linemen creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before, they always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
Robinson with another carry. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it.
Here comes third and about a foot.
Robinson will try to pick it up, and Robinson will not get there. Great defense at the point of attack, going to stop him short of the first. Fourth down, Cousins. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. Hand off to Robinson out of the shotgun. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
That's a play to take note of there for the defense. I think in the future, if you're going to try and block him, maybe you get a guard to help double team him and try and steer him out of the play. They should have done it on that snap.
Cousins now. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete.
Well, that's a defense coordinator's got to be happy with that result. They took away all options downfield and forced the incompletion.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Now Cousins sees something. He's going to change this around. On third down, he'll drop to throw. Got an open man. It's McLeod. And he gets this only to the 41. Not near enough for the first. An audible here to get a new look. Now Cousins on fourth down. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. A gutsy call. Turns out to be a good one, though. First down on a pickup of 11.
Not liking the look. They'll change the play.
Play fake. Cousins. Into the hands of London. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field, and just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
They'll run with Robinson. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. Two of their 3 red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. To throw, Cousins. Touchdown, Falcons! Kirk Cousins with three touchdown passes now in the afternoon. And the Falcons have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. Koo now for the point after. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And this will wind up way short of the landing zone, so that's going to move the ball all the way up to the 40-yard line. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point. But it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a 2nd and 10. Now Tua. This one complete to Jalen Waddle. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Couple of Alabama guys there. Tua to Waddle for the Miami first. Now a give, right side, right. And he'll be taken down at about the 45. We have played 3 quarters. Back now here on EA Sports. It's Dolphin football, but they trail here as we get set for the 4th. Here's 2nd and 7. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. Caught left side. It's Beckham. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Dolphin first down.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the 4th. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
And they'll send the tight end in motion. On 1st and 10, it's Mostert. On a nice burst there as he'll take this inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. 45 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
They'll bring a tight end in motion left. On play action, here's Tua. Getting this out to the flat, Mostert. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. A run with Mostert up the middle. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down, and as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Second down, here's Mostert again. And he stopped after a gain of 1. Not enough. Still a yard to go on 3rd down.
Brandon, one thing about blitzes, they really confuse offensive linemen at times. And what you have to do is lock in on the guy right in front of you. If you don't, you saw the end result. Defensive tackle ended up making the play.
Tua gonna throw.
He's got his running back out of the backfield. Touchdown, Dolphins. Devon Achane
from 6 yards away.
And the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying this game here in the final minutes.
Sanders now to add the extra point. And oh, he missed it. No good. And they'll remain down by a point. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss.
And this is not going to wind up anywhere near the landing zone, so this will be blown dead, and they'll move it up to the 40.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking, my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while because I just can't slow these guys down. They've got to figure out a way to disrupt these offenses. And typically, one guy makes a big play, and that can help change things.
They'll be looking for disruption on both sides right now. Fourth quarter, 2 minutes on the clock in a tight one-point game. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Robinson up the middle. And this will be a Falcons first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. They'll run again here with Robinson.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
Ball at the 40 here for second and 5. A give left side to Robinson. And even though he gets out of bounds to stop the clock, it's not going to matter. That first down, going to be enough to write a finish to this one. On the give, here's Robinson. And he's got it down to the 28.
Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in the game.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation, and taking care of the football, paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball.
Now a second and 6. Out of the gun, they give to Robinson.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
Maybe the old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. It's a gain of 8 there, and that should be enough to seal the victory.